It's time for you to go back home, Major, and leave mine.
So there's a scene in the first episode of the series where, without revealing too many spoilers, where the Indian soldiers, are forced to surrender.
Yes.
And
British Indian soldiers.
The British Indian soldiers. And your character,
yes,
has a very strong reaction in,
yes,
that moment. He says, okay, he stays true to his ideals in that moment,
yeah,
right? And he stands up and says, even though everyone else is thinking a certain way, I will think the way I want to.
Mm.
Now, I'm just curious, on set,
mm,
when you're given a certain direction,
mm,
and maybe you agree with it or you don't agree with it, do you feel comfortable enough to kind of be like, nah, I feel very strongly about this, that I shouldn't do this, and this is where I want to go with the character?
See, at the end of the day, cinema is a director's medium.
Mm.
So you can have jamming sessions with the director, you can,
yeah,
sit, and that's why we have extensive readings before we start filming, so,
yeah,
that whatever doubts and all are there, you clear it out. And having said so, even when you come on set, a lot of things change.
Mm.
You know, you can start thinking about it in a certain way since you've started filming it. So yeah, I mean, you can have a different take, but at the end of the day, it's the director's medium.
Yeah.
If the director says that, no, this is how I see it, then you have to change your point of view and try to understand that if he is saying it, because he's also lived with it for a very long time, he's making it, he knows the characters in and out as much as you do probably because you're playing it, but at the end of the day, it's his vision.
Mm.
It's his vision that you're translating on the celluloid. So if he says that, no, this is how I see the character, and so, you know, and nobody will actually be so rigid that they would bind you in a in anything. So there's always, even like really good directors understand that when an actor comes, he or she will bring a lot more to the character, and they'll have their own take. So I think the best characters are formed when they meet together.
Yeah,
you know,
I mean, a good idea is a good idea.
Yeah, and good ideas are good ideas. But if it, you know, even if it's a good idea, sometimes it doesn't fit in the whole. See, because directors see the whole thing. We see our part, we see our arc.
Yeah.
The director knows about everything.
Mm.
You know, so that he knows about all the permutation combinations, where fits what. So having known all of those things, if he still feels that ke nahi ye thoda sa, it's not what I envisioned, then you sit and you try to understand why that is, and you try to play it that way. Yeah.
How about you?
No, I feel like you can't change the key point of the story, you know, like,
yeah,
the whole point of,
yeah,
this is that you can't change, like, you can't be like, this scene, like, you know, I feel differently, because that you can't change the motive of a scene.
Yeah.
But of course, if you feel like a particular line or a particular, like, whatever, like your reaction or whatever, could be done differently, you know, that you could definitely sit and discuss with the director, and directors are more open to those ideas because they also obviously feel like it's only human, you're playing human characters. So they're also okay listening to a different human approach, you know,
yeah,
so that can change, but definitely not the story point.
But I mean, ideally, you would hope for a receptive director. Right?
Definitely.
But that's what, now receptive director doesn't mean that main jo bolu wo hamesha.
Haan, correct.
Haan,
correct.
It's vice versa.
Yeah, yeah.
It's both ways,
yeah,
right? So a reception is not just about
just
because I think it's right. No, it's, if you have to be receptive, then even you have to be receptive. It goes,
yeah,
both the ways. Even you need to understand that you can also,
yeah,
you have this idea, but it cannot fit as well.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. I mean, also because when it's a story, mostly when you have different like opinions and different ideas, it works better always, you know,
because
if a single track works, then it'll only work with people who have that single track, because we all have different thoughts,
yeah,
you know,
yeah.
So you may like something, but I may not like it, or he may like something else. So for people to mutually like one product, you need to have different like ideas in it, so people can relate to different things in them.
True. A key, I wouldn't want to call it a cliche, but a key part of a war movie or a war story is that rousing speech that you have to give,
yes,
to the troops, you know.
Sunny's given many.
You've given many, huh? Now, how do you make it, like, obviously you've seen the Bravehearts, you've seen Mel Gibson, Gerard Butler, Evo. What do you do to make it your own? I mean, obviously the words are different, but then you don't want to kind of be compared to 10 different people, that was the speech, that was the speech.
Yeah, I think if you understand that motivation, then it becomes your own. then you don't have to shout it unnecessarily. I mean, although I have. There are many lines that I have, because it required a high voltage, high volume throw in that particular scene. But it can also be spoken like this, you know. You can inspire people by just talking like this. So yeah, it's just, if you just need to understand where it's coming from for your character.
So I'm very curious about your character. Yeah. She's grown up in Singapore, and I'm just curious, as when you were preparing for the role, obviously there's a different idea of your own country that you have when you haven't grown up in it.
Correct.
So how did you kind of figure that out? What was the sweet spot of that character? How do you maintain that believable level of, I feel for my country, even though I don't live in it?
Yeah, I think that was a very difficult part to understand that. Yeah. And I, in all honesty, I wouldn't say I've understood 100%, because you always take this, you always find an inspiration from within yourself. So I've definitely read upon, spoken to people, all of that. But I think that the fact that Maya had this sense of, like, she missed out on a sense of belonging, you know. Like, imagine living in, all I could do was imagine, you know. Like, I would just go back to being like, imagine if you were living in a country today where people didn't speak the same language, where someone else completely ruled you, like an outsider, you know. So even in your own home, you were an outsider, and how would that make you feel? So that's my only thought process that went into how would I feel.
Yeah. I'm always curious to know this. How important do you think as actors is it to agree with the messaging of the story? Because like you said, it's a director's vision, and sometimes you have no say in it, right? And sometimes you might agree with it, sometimes you might not. Especially in a story like this, where people can be divided with the stance that you've taken.
Yeah.
And you guys have no control over the messaging. And so I'm just curious, how important is it for you guys when you sign on to a project to agree with it, or is it important at all? Do you have to agree?
100%. You have to. Otherwise, you can't be a part of that thing.
Yeah.
I mean, if you don't believe in it, then why are you even a part of it? So if I don't believe in a message of a particular film or a series that I'm a part of, then I wouldn't be a part of it.
Yeah.
Because it wouldn't come that honestly, you know, and I think the audience is really intelligent now. They want to see honest performances. So if you're not honest with, like,
I will not be able to give inputs, because if I don't believe in it, how do I understand any of it?
Correct.
So how do I give any of my inputs?
Yeah.
Because my inputs then will be biased by what Sunny thinks, not by what the character thinks.
Correct.
So it's like, then you rather not be a part of it.
Yeah.
And do you think the message is important? Because in the end of the day, I mean, you can appreciate the filmmaking, you can appreciate all the technical things, but then if the audience goes away thinking that something that you think that they should not.
No, see, everybody is subject to their own opinion. I mean, we are trying to say something that we believe in. Somebody else might not believe in it. Somebody might trash us for it and say, "Ke, arre, ye kya hai? Ye aisa to nahi hua tha, ye waisa nahi hua tha, and I don't believe in it." Okay.
Yeah, like, you can't control people's interpretation of things. So it's art. Art can be interpreted in, like, many ways. It's so fluid that you can't, like, some people are going to like it, some people are not going to like it, some people are going to take something else from it, you know?
And that's how it should be.
Yeah.
I mean, otherwise there's no art.
True.
That's how it should be. That's how anything grows in a society.
Yeah. All the best.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.